Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Bishopsgate Institute. Welcome to all of the lovely, real, living humans in the room who've joined us for the concert in person, our lovely socially distanced audience, you are very welcome. And welcome to those joining us on Facebook Live or on catch-up, because people, thousands of people have been watching these videos, not at the time of the concert, but watching them later, so the reach has been enormous. Thank you all for joining us. Welcome to our lunchtime concert. As many of you will know, if you've read the programme notes or looked at our website, the reason that these lunchtime concerts happen here at Bishopsgate Institute is inspired by someone called Dame Myra Hess. Now, Dame Myra Hess, during the Second World War, believed that even though the government had closed the theatres and closed the concert halls and closed the galleries because they felt it was too much of a risk or people should be busy doing other things, she believed that in difficult times people need something to inspire them to get through, to fight, to keep going. And it seems even more relevant now, perhaps, than it has done in recent years, that we're able to provide this. So thank you very much for coming. We are a charity, and we do pay our musicians, insist on paying our musicians, but obviously these concerts are free. So if anybody would like to make a donation to support our work and these concerts, in the room there is a rather lovely green luminous contactless device just across by the entrance, which will take some money from your card, or you can donate online. We would be very grateful. I should also point out that to my right, as well as the lovely Daniel, is the lovely Myra the Steinway. So this was Myra Hess's Steinway. Actually, under the normal circumstances, I'd allow you up here to inspect the soundboard because it's signed by Harry Steinway. It was presented to Myra Hess when she retired. This piano came to us when she died in the 1960s and has been our house piano for swing events and for musicals and for concerts ever since. But the fact that Myra inspired the Institute to run lunchtime concerts from 1948 to continue her work, and the fact that we have her fabulous Steinway here, brings it all together. Today, we are delighted to welcome Nina and Daniel. Nina is actually not a stranger to the space at all, because she is a regular with the London Musical Theatre Orchestra, which is our orchestra in residence and with whom we've done a number of fabulous projects. We also have a world premiere today, which I'm super excited about. You'll see from the programme notes the range of material, and Nina will talk us through it, but I'm super excited. Thank you so much, both of you, for joining us. So looking forward to this. Thank you very much, Nina and Daniel.
Thank you very much. It's really lovely to be in a hall. It's really lovely to be performing again. And I am absolutely thrilled that Daniel is here with me today to do this concert. The theme for today's concert is the outdoors, the flute outdoors, which really is an excuse for me to do a whistle-stop tour through 200 years of my most favourite flute music. We're starting with the Schubert Trockene Blumen. I think that our job as musicians is to tell the story, that the composer had in his head, in his heart, or her head, when the piece was being written. And the theme of this piece is, of course, unrequited love. And you can hear all the way through the juxtaposition between that awful despair and that wonderful hope. So this is Schubert's Trockene Blumen, written in 1824. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Dan's gone for a lie down after that one. We're now jumping rather a number of years to 1913, and this piece by Debussy was written as incidental music for a play. It's an iconic flute piece. I tremble at the thought of playing it in public, but it is such a marvellous piece, I thought I had to include it. The narrative here is from Greek mythology, and Pan is half man, half goat, and he's waking up in the forest. You can practically hear him stretching in the first few phrases. He's up to no good, Pan. He spies the water nymph Syrinx and chases after her. And I think you can really hear his rage in the second page of the piece. So this is Debussy's Syrinx. Not such a big leap in time this time, only 5 years. This was written in 1918, but it's a whole different sound world. The preface to this piece is, in a Dublin street at dusk, two wandering street musicians are playing, which is a little bit like one of those intriguing first lines of a novel that sort of throws you into the action and poses more questions than it answers. Where were they going? What were they doing? What were they playing? And it's a really lovely piece. So this is In Ireland by Hamilton Harty.
Thank you.
This is what you might like to think of as the comedy item in the programme. I really like this piece, and I think it should be played more often. But I had this really great idea, of recording the alto flute part and then playing with it. Well, of course, that's simple. It's given me nightmares. But it is a really great piece. It's called The Conversation Between Two Parakeets. And for those of you who don't know, parakeets are sort of feral parrots. I think a colony of them escaped from a London zoo. There is another story that apparently Jimi Hendrix released a pair of parakeets in Carnaby Street in 1960. Who knows? Anyway, they're all over London now. We've certainly have quite a few in the park behind our house, and I think Fonse really brilliantly depicts their chattering and bickering and gossiping. So this is four movements from A Conversation Between Two Parakeets, which is for flute and alto flute.
Sorry, that was a complete fail. I will try that again, probably with the sound turned off on my phone. Thank you.
Thank you.
And now to our final piece, which is the most exciting piece because it's new. And before we play that, I would just like to say thank you very much to Bishopsgate for asking me to play, for asking us both to play. It's been a real joy to play in public again like this. And I would like to thank Freddie Tapner for suggesting me. He's amazing. And I would finally like to thank Jeff for writing this piece and for trusting me with it. It's been really lovely to see him and talk to him and work with him on this piece. And I think it's a really beautiful addition to the flute repertoire, and I'm sure lots of people will want to play it. So thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy this. This is the Awakening of Spring.
Thank you.
Very much.
My apologies for the slightly disjointed. I wasn't sure whether they were going to do an encore. I hope you enjoyed that. I thought that was exquisite. It's such a pleasure to share such gorgeous live music with you all on a Friday, whether you're here in person or whether you're joining us online. It's a series of 9 concerts, and it's 3 instruments, 3 ways, as you probably read on the website. So there'll be other flutes, there'll be other pianos, there'll be other voices. They end on the 27th of November for this sequence, and then they resume after Christmas. All the details are on our website. Thank you so much for coming. Once again, we provide these for free because we feel it's important in difficult times, but that doesn't mean that they don't cost us anything. So if anyone would like to make a donation, if you've enjoyed yourselves, there is a contactless donation point in the corner of the room for those who are here, and via the website for those who are joining us online. Once again, thank you so much for joining us. Look forward to seeing you again next week or very soon. Thank you.